Yeah.
Sounds good. Thanks, guys.
Yeah. You bet.
B-Dubs, how about we kick it over to a video before we launch into some leaderboards and promotions?
Let's do it.
I'm usually pretty skeptical about anything I see on the internet.
At eAgency, they bring the matches to you.
When you're answering these questions, you're thinking about who and what you really are.
This isn't about searching through thousands of resumes to see who's a good fit.
They have your profile, they have someone else's profile, and then they match you.
We use a scientific system to help you find someone who's looking for someone like you.
So we have our off days and things, but you know, I finally found someone that will really listen to me, and finally someone that will work with me.
Hiring sites offer you a resume and an email address. At eAgency, we match you based on compatibility at the very deepest levels.
The person I found on eAgency was exactly the agent I thought I was getting.
I don't think anyone, no matter how old and useless they are, should ever give up.
You never know. Your next match could be your top producer.
I was just passing through, and I got a ding on my BlackBerry, and now I have a job.
Find everything you're looking for on eAgency.com. It all starts with a personality profile, a $50 value, yours free, when you join eAgency.com.
Don't you doubt me!
Do you think I need a breath mint?
Best.
If you're new with us, that is just a small preview of what you're going to find at conference also, as we take our having fun and getting stuff done very seriously. Well done there.
That is a fun one.
Ayers absolutely slays that one for me. Yes. Danny Young as well.
Yeah. You got to, you know, knowing the safe pores, I love that, you know, they get spotlighted on that one. Just Sarah's loving the limelight, I'm certain.
Oh yeah. You talk about somebody that wants to be front and center on stage, right, Sarah? Our good buddy. Speaking of which, Sarah's been doing amazing things at the corporate office behind the scenes and filling in some project work and doing some really cool stuff. So much gratitude there.
Absolutely.
Well, let's get it kicked off, guys. We're going to talk about some leaderboards and do some promotions before we get it over to Making It Happen, Dave Lappin. And once we finish up the leaderboards, we're going to have a couple of cool announcements to get you guys fired up and get you ready for conference in Denver. So let me see if I can do this properly. It's been a minute. Let me know if I get it right, B-Dub. So.
Sounds good. Well, it's still... popping up on mine. I may have the same problem. My lag is a little bit low today. So I'm seeing your Zoom thing, not the deck. So I can...
How about now?
Let's see. I'll see if anyone else... there you go. You got it. You got it. Good. Bravo. Okay. You got an A for effort, E, an A+ for attitude, and C for skills. Keep going.
I'll take all those things.
All right.
We'll take all those things. All right. So looking at for attitude, effort, and skills coming up with Dave Lappin. We're also going to be digging into our leaderboards and B-Dubs. Let's see. It is struggling a little bit for me.
All right.
Top 10 new riders in APV. Number 3, Schmil Edelman with 3,500.
You want me to fire up here? Hold on.
Go for it. My computer does not like it.
Hopefully... hopefully, let me get this thing presented here. Where are we at? Gotta view my. Now I'm getting. There we go. View. That's what I want to see. You got to give me a D minus for skills now because I'm not used to presenting in the drive here. There we go. Slideshow. There we go. Thank you. Took me a minute. All right. Now, y'all tell me, can you see my screen, Spivey?
Gotcha.
All right. Let's fire away here. Go for it.
Number three, Shmuel Edelman. Number two, Kay Schweizer. Number one, Nadu Stackhouse with $3,700 in APV.
It's a good top 10 list.
Mm-hmm.
Love it. Top 10 producers,
APV, Manny Manuel, that boy Manny, Joshua Killian, and Haley Walker. Congratulations, 33,000.
A tight one. 31, 32, 33. Bravo.
Top 10 producers and app count, Maria Maestas with Monique Al-Rali coming in at tied for first with Holly Alien at 21 applications.
Let's go.
Top two Medicare supplement producers, Brad Higgins and Sabrina Fernbacher.
Boom.
Top five disability income producers, number three, Alicia Metzen, number two, Melanie Ray, and number one, Richard Borza.
All right.
Top five IUL producers, number three, Joshua Killian, number two, Maduri Wai, and number one, Michael Hettinger. 27,000. Nicely done. Great. Gotta say, B-dubs, IULs are on the rise based on the economy and the way the market is reacting right now. No surprise, guys. But for the last 2 weeks, we have been shattering records out there across Symmetry Nation with IUL production. So pay attention, get with your upline, make sure that you're not missing those opportunities right now, and specifically with what they have going on in today's market.
That's right. Yep. Resma and crew and others working hard on scripting, behind the scenes, training, all those things. So outstanding.
Absolutely. Top three annuity producers, Larry Williams, John Berlin, number one, Steve Barnett with $552,000 in face amount. Top three debt-free life producers, number three, Angela Clark. Number two, Manny Manuel. And number one, Chad Clark. Nicely done, Chad.
All right.
Top new riders, top base shop new riders. We got a tie for second with Dana Elks and Samuel Fine, followed by Ashley and Tyler Harris. No stranger to the leaderboards for sure. Top direct new riders, three-way tie. Look at there.
That's right.
George and Janet, Edward, Christopher, Clark. Congratulations, you guys.
Snaz in the house.
Top base shop, Snaz. We got 13 agency owners tied for first, along with Karen Earhart, David Whiteman with one SNA. And the top directs, Jacob Pogue led the way with three SNAs, followed by John Ziller tied with 11 other directs.
Let's go.
How do you think they break those ties when there's 11 directs or 13 agency owners?
That's a great question. Coin flip.
You think it's because they like John Ziller more?
I think it's because, I would say knowing the quantitative and unbiased nature of our data and reporting people, I'm certain it's either a intentionally random coin toss or some algorithm. How's that? Good to see David Whiteman up there. I don't know if I've said this before with David on the call, if he is. In our Quility People Insights, People Analytics platform, David Whiteman was way up there in psychological safety and creating an environment where people felt like, man, they were valued and heard and appreciated. And man, that goes such a long way, right? Positive, intentional communication, pulling before we push in communication. And David was highly, highly rated amongst his peers. I'm hesitant to say he was like number one in that category. There was a couple other people close, but he might have been. I'll have to look back at that. But you know, shout out to David for the hard work you've done on yourself. I got to work with him a couple of years ago, a little bit in conjunction with my work with John Ziller. So good to see those guys up there.
Very well done.
All right.
Go ahead, B-Dubs.
Yeah, welcome to all the, or congratulations, maybe welcome to all you seasoned new agents. Adrienne Emmons, Krista Brown, Delana Charlotte, Dana Fowler, Elizabeth Kalovich, Heidi Armbrust, Jay Rollman, Jada Dawn Alantaga, Jeremy Ritchie, Jose Garza, Caitlin McNamara, Kyler Long, LaShonda Seymour, Lindsay Crawford, and Tiana Simon, along with their corresponding mentors, alongside in parentheses, shout out to all the parentheses. Is that the plural? Parentheses. There you go. Congratulations.
Very well done. For those of you that are new, seasoned new agents mean 6 apps in the first 6 weeks since joining the company. These individuals statistically have gone on to show that they are thriving individuals in a new industry 12 months after joining. So for all you agency owners out there in the parentheses, congratulations to you as well.
That's right. All right. We are on to weekly leaderboards, key leader. Let's see what we got here. We got my screen that doesn't want to, there we go. All right. We're just going to produce all those. How you want to talk about these are, we do have some loaded leaderboards and they're, I kind of pop these up now and they're a little bit overwhelming, right? Talking about skills breakdown under pressure. Anyway, we talk about the top one in each category. Are you going to go all three?
No, we'll alternate. You go first.
All right. We're going to look at APV, James Larson, Cassandra Mack, and Emmanuel for key leader. Do we have a nickname for him, for Emmanuel? Is it like Manny Manny?
I know him as Manny.
Manny?
Manny. It's Manny. I think Mike Resma and Ditson would probably give me several other cool nicknames. But when I met him, I just knew him as one of the coolest individuals you'll ever get to spend time with.
Nice.
What do you think, Ditson? Manny got
a great guy. Great guy. And it, honestly, if you saw him, he was in the DFL leaderboards too. I wonder why.
Outstanding. All right. Top key leader, top for recruits, Amy Anderson, Amanda Torma, and Wesley Engbrecht. Sorry. I don't know if I've ever had to pronounce that one out loud. And Amanda Torma, Steve Montgomery, and Barbara Anson for new writers. Congratulations.
Agency owner for APV, number 3, John Paul Vetter, number 2, Christy Stadola, number 1, Jamie Susi. Uh-huh. Jamie, you hear me? Pronounce your name correct. Mm-hmm. Number 3 in total recruits, Jamie. Number 2, Alan Jeff Wolbert. And number 1, Christy Miller. Good job, Christy. Top new riders, Gregory Hassman, number 3. Greg. Look at there. I try to combine Gil and Grigio. Gail Grigo with number 2 and number 1 tied for first place there with EJ Johnson. Got to spend some time with EJ Johnson, had a spring tour here recently. Awesome guy.
They're all tied on that. They're all tied on that bottom line. Karen and Kelly as well.
Nice. We see you over there.
Yeah, for sure. All right. Weekly leaderboards for agency director Larry Ann Griffin at 94, Sarah Reinecke at 105, and David Alvarado, 161. Recruits Mark Newbauer, Ben Safapour, whilst he was out and about enjoying some beautiful time. And Larry Ann Griffin, same thing for new writers for across the board, Samuel, Mark, Larry, Jeff, and Roddy. Roddy, the king of dad jokes on Facebook. If you don't follow him, you need to. Jessup, how's that?
Oh, he put out a good one last night. If you haven't seen that, look it up. Yeah. Become one of my dear treats as I'm going to bed at night.
Nice.
Weekly leaderboard, agency director, number 3, Trey Adderson, Gloutier, 89,000. Josh Manzano, good go, Josh, 102,000. And Eileen Ballmer with 162,000 APV for the week. Congratulations, buddy. For the recruits side, number 3, Beth Maddox. Number 2, Josh Hershey, and number one, Mike Casey with 12. Talking about new riders, again, we've got some ties going on with Derek Brock, Dana Eltz, Amy Fine. Number 2, Christy Woodbury, and number 1, Eileen Ballmer. Get on it, girl.
That's good. Man, just quick shout out. I see Amy Fine, Mike Casey. I see the Rifes up there. I know they were in fourth, but they all work with one of our Symmetry coach is Tim O'Neill, and we're going to be posting a registration soon in HQ under training and Symmetry coaching for a cohort that he's leading on agency building and strategy and execution. We're going to rally the troops for one last time as he launches that cohort. Tim, just a great professional EOS implementer, if you know our EOS tools that we use, and fun to see so many up there that are working with Mr. Tim. All right. Managing Vice Presidents, MVP, Marlon Faulkner, Christopher Clark, and Brad and Kira Ganey. John Ziller for recruits, Griff Martin, Chris Cook with the blowout on that one. Let's go, Griff. Step it up, homie. And Chris Cook again, Marlon Faulkner, the marvelous one, and Christopher Clark for new writers. Congratulations to all you MVPs. Much respect to all of you. Appreciate you.
Senior Vice President, number 3 for APV, Nate Alford. Number 2, Mike and Jen Colburn. Number 1, Kyle and Lisa Kimbrell, $270,000. Great job. Great week. Total number of recruits, we've got number 3, Mike and Sarah Pappas. Tied for 2nd, Kyle and Lisa Kimbrell. And number 1 overall for the recruits and the Senior Vice President, the Mank Tank, Scott Mank. Congratulations, Scott. New riders. Once again, got some ties across the board. Scott Mank, Nate Alford, Kyle and Lisa Kimbrell, George and Janet Matthews. And first place with 4, Mike and Jennifer Colburn.
Let's go. All right, EVPs, Mr. Sean Shannon, Miranda Martin, and Darren Stubbs. Great to hear you on the Builder's Call, sir. And Miranda Martin, Darren Stubbs, Sean Shannon for recruits. And surprise, surprise, Darren Stubbs, Sean Shannon, Miranda Martin for new writers. Great job, EVPs. In the house, that's like a little kind of tight ecosystem to compete with there, isn't it?
Do you think they plant, do they call and coordinate that? Decide who's going to take which place and what category?
That's right. All right. One more app and you got it. All right. Love it.
For associate partners, number 3, Ryan and Michelle Miller. Number 2, Ashley and Tyler Harris. Number 1, Mr. Linwood Watkins. For total recruits, we got Carl Miller, number 3, Ryan and Michelle Miller, number 2. And Lynn Watkins coming in first place. Total new riders, Ryan and Michelle Miller finishing 3rd. Ashley and Tyler Harris in 2nd. And once again, Mr. Linwood Watkins with a total of 11 new riders in the week. Congratulations, as we lovingly refer to the circus bear.
Really? The circus bear? I don't know that story.
I forget where that originated from, but... I remember Brandon and Casey always would lovingly call him the circus bear.
I like that. I'll have to find out. Coming for you, Lynn Watkins. I want the story. It was Lynn, right? That's who you were talking about?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. I'm coming. Coming for you. All right. How about on the senior partners? Smith Agency at 470, Mr. Danny Young, 574, and topping the charts at 1.1, Edward Pritchett. Same across on the recruits. We got Danny Young at 35, Jacob Pogue at 40, Edward Pritchett at 59. And for new riders, Smith Agency at 8, Jacob Pogue at 8, and Edward Pritchett at 14. Shout out to all the senior partners.
Linwood texted me and said that he actually got that nickname from his brother Colby from their backpacking days. And Linwood said, let's just say that I tumbled a lot. Oh God, I love Linwood. Yes. Managing partners, number 3, Mr. Brian Delaney coming in with a strong $345,000. Kevin Purdy, $551,000. Marshall Whalen, $967,000 APV for the week. Congratulations. These individuals, guys, I just can't thank them enough for their time, the energy, and the amount they're pouring into the company and the feedback to continue to grow the organization. So many great leaders out there, but special shout out to these individuals. Recruits coming in, number 3, Brian Delaney, Kevin Purdy, 2nd place. Marshall Whalen with 109. You heard Darren Stubbs and Eric Andrick talk about this. Marshall Whalen is no stranger to recruiting and putting people into the seats in Denver and at conference and letting the system do the heavy lifting. Congratulations. You see that paid off again in new riders, 17 for Marshall Whalen, 7 for Purdy, and 3 for Mr. Delaney.
Outstanding. And then directs, we got Dave Alvarado, Kevin Purdy, Jacob Pogue. For APV, we've got Edward Pritchett, Chris Cook, and Jacob Pogue at 32 for recruits. and a tie across the board from right to left. Purdy, Pogue, Matthews, Pritchett, and Clark at three new writers for the directs.
Top base shops, number three, Gus Villagran. Nice job, Gus. We got David Alvarado, number two, Ashley and Tyler Harris. Man, they are on the tear on the recruiting and building a base shop side. Congratulations to you guys. Total recruits, number three, Rob Puckett. Number two, Ben Sapafor. And number one, Mark Newbauer. Congratulations, Mark, on the recruiting efforts. New riders, several ties there for third place. But Mr. Pritchett, Devin Johnson, Ashley, and Tyler. That does not look like Samuel Fine.
we're like one a week. I think we're good for name that face or fine, whatever that would be, whatever.
Our apologies, Mr. Fine. I assume that you are supposed to be in that category, but we're just going to put Mark Newbauer's name down. Our pitcher again, Mark, it's because you're such a good looking guy. We just wanted to use your photo twice.
That's true.
First place, Dana Elks with two. Nicely done.
Nicely done. Oh man, promotion time. Let's get ready. This is exciting. I can't believe we get to do promotions. This is, I don't know if this is a first. Feels like it is. It's been a little minute. But I'll start. How's that? Well, elite producer, man. Bo Hirschfield and James William McCray get to sport that EP logo in the EP initials, elite producer. So mad producers. Congratulations to those two individuals. Any comments on that, Spive?
Man, just it's a title that you keep, like a lot of our levels of leadership, you continually move on. It's the point, right, of the system to continue to develop and grow. Love seeing these elite producers, these top producer rankings, because they mean so much as you continue to build your own agency, that you yourself are there in the front leading the way and know exactly how to help them protect more families. So congratulations to all of our elite producers, top producers, getting the promotion here. Brenda Smith, Cassandra Mack, Jamie Cortine, Jamie Jamafoot, and Patrick Duff. All getting promoted to top producer this month. Congratulations, guys, for your efforts.
Absolutely. And team leaders moving through the ranks. Congrats. This is a big stepping stone on your way to key leader and then agency owner. And we know many of these individuals have lots of momentum heading there. So congrats to Barbara Canis, Christopher Rowland, Frank Capistrano, Kristen Mothershead, Melissa Post, Michael Matthews, Michelle Hatchett, and Reed Hills, and Rocco Pearson. Congratulations on that team leader promotion. Keep the building efforts full steam ahead as you grow that momentum to key leader. Speaking of key leaders, over to you, Todd.
Yes, sir. Chandra Wittenberger, James Chris Craig, Jordan Little, Kelly Bush, Nancy Hardy, and Mr. Sam Fine Sr. all getting promoted to key leaders. Congratulations, guys, and excellent work, and so cool to see them actually really get geared up for agency owner.
That's right. Speaking of agency owners, six agency owner promotions. I always love hearing Brandon and Casey reflect back on how many agency owners they used to promote in a quarter, a year. And, you know, six agency owners is quite a step for the month, isn't it? Brady Moss.
They used to get, on average, I believe it was 8 to 10 the first 5 years, 8 to 10 agency owners a year.
Yeah.
Now, at this point, guys, we're approaching almost 300 agency owners that that are a part of the Symmetry family at this point, guys. It's just absolutely phenomenal growth. The coolest part about it, Brian, I get this question a lot when I'm doing team huddles, is, you know, this company's had such phenomenal growth, and it's very easy to think I might have missed the big wave. Am I too late? Is there enough opportunity left? And I think agency owner is one of the primest examples you can use to show that we're just getting started, because we're now putting out the amount of agency owners on any given month that Symmetry was putting out on any given year, the first few years, guys. So we're just getting started with this thing.
That's right. That's right. Yeah. The hard work to become business owners on their way to the investor quadrant. Maybe some of these folks are in that place. If you know cash flow quadrants, such a gift to be able to have that, to be able to have that legacy for your family. And I love the stories. Never gets old hearing stories of just people being able to experience the benefits of that and the blessing of that from their hard work. So congrats to Brady Moss, Manuel Guarola, Chris Leek, Sarah Tubbs, Lisa Brown, and Todd Lamarck. Congratulations to all of you business owners, agency owners in the house. Some ADs.
Yes, sir. Agency directors, congratulations. Douglas Dorr Sr. and Mr. Stephen Paul Jackson. Congratulations to you guys breaking out agency owners, becoming an agency director.
And how about those RADs, regional agency directors? Abra Brown, congratulations. Jeremy Whitaker, congratulations. And Mr. Gus Villagran, who we just heard from last week, congratulations to three of you as you continue your summit to the top contract level, the top of the company. Bumping Mr. Scott Mank up to EVP. I stole that one from him. But go ahead. You want to say something about
it? Got it. Get always excited to see Scott's team and his success. And just a wonderful individual to be around. Congratulations, Scott, on executive vice president, buddy.
Hard worker. Absolutely. Gus hitting 115 too, contract level. Good for him.
We actually had two. We had two. We missed it. We didn't get Marty Valor's name up there in his pretty face, but congratulations to the Valor Agency and hitting the 115 promotion along with Gus Villagran, who we all did get to see just recently on the Builders Call.
That's right. All right. Now we get into some fun stuff, Mr. Spivey. Some rollouts, some new announcements, and let's talk about leads, available standing orders, forecasted growth with new statewide SLOs. My home state of New Jersey. Let's go. I might be calling my mom. She's quite a sales lady, Grandma Campanosi. And she's actually inquired about that a few times. She's
Get
me on that phone. Get me on phone. I'll do that. Might have to give her a buzz.
I'm always wanting to spend a couple seconds with Brendan and Casey are going over the slide just to make sure we're clear, guys. This does not mean leads currently in inventory. This is forecasted system showing that if we had new standing lead orders placed in these states, then we would be able to start the mailing process, start the digital communication and platforms, get them all fired up to generate leads. So this means that if you're looking for a place to start a new standing lead order, you're needing more additional lead flow. These are some highly encouraged states right now. To where you should be considering putting in those standing orders.
That's right. Man, we got to move. We got to give Dave Lappin and team some time. All right. Upcoming events. We got a webinar hosted by SVP of Activation and GM of MyQuility, Ethan Drum, and Director of Member Services, Brittany Torbett, on Quility RX. So a little bit of equipping and training there, Thursday at 11. And as always, DFL, debt-free living with VP of Advanced Market Solutions, Mr. Resma, Tuesday the 26th at 11. So hit up those two events as you move forward. A couple Connect events as well. I'll keep moving here, Spivey. I'll let you do a couple
of
big tee-ups. So, the Connect platform, what they're doing on Instagram, and this is going to be incredible. I mean, just the short time I've had with Danielle, unbelievable leader, great background, great competence, just great human being. So they're going to be talking about switching plans and leaps of faith, Danielle's path to SVP of data products. And so can't imagine that is not going to be unbelievable. It wouldn't matter the topic with Danielle talking. She is outstanding. So that'll be a great one, July 27th. Tune into that. And July 28th, we got back-to-back my journey of breaking barriers with Yun Mi. Is that how you pronounce that, Todd? I met Yun Mi at...
Yun Mi.
Yeah, in Orlando. So she's going to be talking about her time spent in the UK financial market, moving from London to Texas and switching from the mortgage business to insurance. And again, lots of transition themes in those talks. So I love Meredith's leadership there and wit and how they're constantly seeking to level up our incredible women leaders in this organization. So two non-miss opportunities for you. Go ahead, Spiv. I'm going to pass the baton for some exciting communication about
national. If you haven't already registered, make sure that you're getting registered. Make sure that you're inviting your friends and family for the Reimagine conference, guys. Reimagine 2020. .com for all your information and place. A couple of key things that are going to be going on while we're out there in Denver. We've got Mr. Rob Dearden. There's going to actually be, I believe Rob's going to be zooming in from California as he continues to film Ridiculousness, but I think it's very cool the feedback we've heard around Rob Dearden. A lot of people know him for the funny TV shows and his time on MTV and through the skateboard community. What a lot of people don't know is how this individual has taken having fun and getting stuff done to a whole new level in his investment, in his business, in his career behind the scene, the way he's transformed himself to be an absolute prolific business individual. And we're looking forward to grabbing the nuggets from that conversation.
Yeah, I think our founders, Brandon, Casey, Brian, I mean, they attract great talent and they attract people of impact. And this is no exception. I mean, Rob is a classic, what has he got, like 17 plus businesses going. You can pick it up in Ridiculousness and his other shows. He's a serial entrepreneur with a heart. You know, he's so creative. It's going to be off the charts. Really, really fun.
Absolutely.
And today, I think we have a new rollout we're about to communicate. You want to let it rip?
Yeah, go for it.
All right. We're good. Frame it up.
Yeah, so keynote speaker, one of the individuals that's going to come in to pour into the system, guys. Jeremy Miner, founder and chairman, 7th Level Global Sales Training Company, author of one of the world's best-selling books, talks about specifically something, Brian Williamson, you've been very engaged in and talking about how it is that we speak to our customer in an ever-changing world and making sure, as always, that we're investing our time and energy to make sure that we are getting the very best in sales education, to make sure that we're staying on the forefront of the new trends out there and making sure that we're staying connected to the people that we serve. So B-Dubs, a little behind the scenes on what you've been talking about.
Yeah, absolutely. We are beyond thrilled. I know some of you commented in the chat last week to have Jeremy Miner. I was on a call with him this morning with Resma and Ditson. I mean, this guy is such an insightful mind. If you follow him on Instagram, which this morning he said, hey, make sure the Symmetry agents start to follow me on Instagram, Jeremy Lee Miner. And he said, hey, if you get any messages in the chat, he's got like 12 full-time people that do his social media. So he's like, just tell him to ignore any marketing, because he's working with us directly. And if you watch his Instagram, you'll get lots of great sales insights. His whole premise is, how do we reduce sales resistance by increasing our sales ability? And what he's really kind of created in this neuro-emotional persuasion questioning. So right now, I mean, this guy's been published in the Wall Street Journal, Forbes magazine, really wants to help us be better problem finders and problem solvers instead of product pushers. And great, great trainer, incredibly gifted. He's working with us right now. I think Casey mentioned this last week, just on revising our sales scripts. He's getting in the weeds of helping us to really evaluate and analyze how are our sales scripting doing, or how can we really kind of bring that up into the new model of selling in a way that will move the needle in your business. And we believe it absolutely will. This will probably be, I think Casey said it last week, like one of the most needle moving things that we've done in a long time in terms of helping you to upskill your sales ability. So can't say enough good things about Jeremy, and excited to have him involved in our business, not just at conference, but in a partnership that we're working on as well behind the scenes. So only great stuff ahead there. So.
Absolutely. Fired up for that. And guys, we've been hearing a lot of questions about this. We're very excited to have our fun while we're out in conference to make sure that we have some time to get in that association piece, guys. So what we're going to do is we're throwing a downtown Denver block party. There's going to be food trucks. There's going to be beer and local company with wine and all kinds of different beverage trucks. We're going to have games up and down the street. We're going to have live music. There's going to be an opportunity for dancing. There's going to be an opportunity for a lot of taking really cool action shots with all of our leadership, all the 120s out there interacting and pouring back in to let you know exactly how they were able to achieve their type of success. But guys, we couldn't think of a better way to celebrate as a company, to block off a piece of around the conference center. We're going to have the streets closed down and be a block party. in just celebration of all of the quality individuals that attend. Going to be so much cool stuff to take place. We're going to have snacks, food, beer, wine, you name it, guys. We do constantly get the question too, can I dress up? You absolutely can dress up. D-Dubs, if you want to wear an outfit, you wear an outfit, brother. You do not have to dress up in a costume. There is no specific theme. We want to make sure everybody is comfortable and everybody feels like they're ready to have a good time and celebrate with, check your local weather reports and make sure that you feel comfortable and dress appropriately. But if you would like to dress up, absolutely bring the fun, wear your costumes, but absolutely not required. So I know we look forward to doing some association and having some big fun.
Yeah, I was hoping to don my Aerosmith rock and roller coaster beanie from like 10 years ago, but I don't know. It's pretty scary looking.
I still think you should rock it.
You think I should rock it? Yeah. Might be a little hot out there. Might be a little hot. All right, man, I get it now, man. All this.
It's new, a lot.
All these new
some announcements and some promotions to go through. It's a lot to get
through. That is a lot of great.
But we definitely do not want to shortchange Dave Lappin and team. So guys, you take a few extra minutes today. Let's get ready to pour in.
Yeah, absolutely. Take your time. Enjoy. Thank you all for all the great work you've been doing, all those great celebrations and promotions. But over to you guys.
All right. Well, thank you guys. Wow. Yeah, you know, just those that Jeremy, I can't wait to hear all the information he's got. He sounds amazing. But thank you guys again. I'm Dave Lappin. I am direct to the one and only John Ziller, and we are in Marshall and Ryan and Carl and Puckett and the whole Wayland organization. And Gretchen and I have been here for 6.5 years. And I know we always say this, but to say that we're grateful and we are excited is an understatement, to say the least. This company is the greatest opportunity I've seen. So what I want to talk about today is, we briefly talked about it when I had the privilege, really, and the honor to be asked to be on here. You think, well, what can I say to contribute to the team, right? What can we say that's going to move the needle? Because there are so many quality people here, and we have so many quality conversations. I mean, with what Darren did today on the builder's call with Eric, I mean, that was an epic call in and of itself. So there's so much great content. I really thought long and hard as to what we can contribute, and I was taught by my mentor at a young age a lot of real simple philosophies that I've tried to follow. In this idea of attitude, effort, and skills, we want to break that down. So what I want to do is, with no further ado, bring on my sister, Bridget. Let me tell you a little bit about Bridget. So when I first got into Symmetry, I did everything wrong. So full disclosure, and meaning I called Bridget and said, you have got to do this. You've got to do this. And so I was all fired up about it. And she said, no, I'm not selling insurance. And this went on for 6 months, probably, you know. And so I had no videos, no three-way calls, no nothing. Just I figured I could handle it. And so my point is, follow the system. And especially when it's warm market, don't give up on people. So Bridge finally came on board, and she is an agency director, and I just can't even begin to tell you how proud I am of her. If you stop and think about, if you're willing to ask your sisters, I have three sisters, Bridge is one of them, to come on board with Symmetry, you got to know it's a good opportunity, right? Talking to somebody in warm markets, one thing. Talking to your family is a whole nother ballgame. So it just speaks to how wonderful our opportunity is. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn it over to Bridge, and we're going to have a brief conversation. I better watch my time because it always gets away from me. And Bridge is going to talk a little bit about the first idea in this little trifecta, which is attitude. So Bridge, why don't you take it over and let's talk a little bit about it, but more importantly, how you apply it to different parts of the business that's helped you to become an agency director.
Sure, absolutely. And like Dave mentioned, I'm Bridget Felix, direct to the one, the only Dave Lappin. And those of you that know Dave know that we have a lot of laughs, a lot of fun, learned a lot, and I'm in direct to Ziller as well and via Whalen Hierarchy. I always forget to say that, so I want to say it today. Mm-hmm. And so thanks for having me on the call too, Dave. These concepts are something we've always trained by back in our other business, and they never, ever disappoint. They're core values. So attitude is the first one. By definition, the Webster definition is it's a way of feeling or acting towards a person, things, you know, your world. And your set of attitudes is your mindset. In other words, how are you thinking about things? So a positive attitude is all about getting in the proper mindset through self-development. So how do we ensure that our attitude is right and that it's going to help us? Well, what we focus on grows. We know that, positive or negative. And if you're struggling and not getting the results that you desire, most cases it's a result of how we're thinking. Tending to your thoughts, what's going in, that's a direct input into your attitude, right? Your thoughts become your words, become your beliefs, lead to your actions, the results, right? We've all heard that, but you kind of have to drill it down. Like, what does that mean? So if you think about this, Dave, in terms of Symmetry, how has Symmetry grown from a handful of agents in 2009 to being a dominating industry leader with momentum that's just growing? And the answer is the founders have developed a system. It's fundamental and transferable. Mm-hmm. It, you know, it counts for all differences in personalities, experience level, industry. It's the reason somebody can come in here with no insurance experience, no sales experience, plug into the system and be very successful. But they need to use the fundamentals of our system. And those are the rules and principles that never change. They're the core. And so mindset and attitude, I'll kind of use those interchangeably. That's the core of what we do at Symmetry. You know, you've heard it said, Symmetry is a self-development company that happens to offer insurance. So when you surround yourself with like-minded people who are committed, you know, to their self-development, getting a little better every day, you have a recipe for a group of resilient, optimistic, growth-minded people. So whatever that is for you, right? It could be reading. It could be taking part in your Huddle Up Book of the Month Club, journaling, listening to a podcast, meditating, exercise, whatever that is for you. But it's critically important to stick to your self-development rituals, you know, especially when life is challenging. So really what self-development does is just strengthens your inner core for the gut punches that'll come. You know, it just allows you, right, to persevere, keep going. So how do we relate that? You know, the importance of self-development and therefore our attitude, right, going into the process. Okay.
Absolutely. So let me stop you there. So you're giving us a combo, right? Attitude, right, and mindset. Mm-hmm. And so I just want to pick up on something that you said. So, because I think some people come here and they think attitude is, well, I'll just be positive, right? Woohoo, I'm just positive. I'm Papa. Well, there's a lot more to it than that, right? So talk about, you know, I think you and I have, you know, we have the same mindset that we came here and we'd been in a system or business with a system. So we like that. But, you know, what this is doing in terms of what the average person can come here and become financially independent, that's hard to find, that kind of vehicle. So talk a little bit about the attitude towards, you know, the system and what can happen if you don't follow it and what happens when you do follow it.
Sure. I mean, your attitude, if you're new here or you're just kind of in that learning curve, you know, your thought needs to be, okay, the company is almost 13 years old. Their system must work. They must be doing something right, right? So that belief, you know, in the beginning, honestly, you're borrowing it, right, from your mentor, right? Like you would call me and say, oh, I just helped two families. You know, I made $1,800 in commission and it was 1 p.m. And you call me and tell me that. I'm like, what am I doing? What am I doing? So, you know, your attitude has to be coachable, kind of all in the beginning, because you don't know. that goes back to the massive action part of it. And so it has to be, this is going to work for me. You have to pull out all the stops. You can't, you know, do it part committed, right? We always say that you can do it part time, but it's not part committed. And so somebody new coming in here, I urge you just to listen to your mentor. Don't worry. You're going to stumble around. You're going to get back up. You're going to be fine. But how you do that is always in your attitude. And kind of, we were taught, Dave, right? You have to kind of guard the doors and windows of your mind, because there's going to be a lot of things coming at you that you're like, well, what do I do with this? And that's what the self-development attitude does. It just keeps you settled down. And look, on the other side of that, if you follow the system, make more money than you ever made in your life. And the technology and the advances that Symmetry is implementing, there's never been a better time than right now to come into our company, because it's the efficiency, the greater reach. And so if you're new coming in, I would just invite you to just take it all in. Don't worry about whether or not, that kind of doesn't make sense. It'll come, but just work on yourself first and everything flows from there.
Right. Yeah, that is so good, Bridget. And we could talk for an hour about the importance of attitude. I just want to drive home something that Bridget said, it's consistency. So how do you, what, and then we'll wrap up with this. What is consistency and how does that look to you in terms of working on your attitude? Like Jim Rohn says, a lot of people are working on their work and they're not working on their thinking. And it's the thinking that makes our work better, and we have to work less the better we think. So talk to us about how you apply that consistency in terms of attitude.
You have to do something every day or most days, right, to fuel your mind in a positive way. And what you need to be aware of, and myself included, is the best time to do it is when you first wake up, before the day kind of gets away from you. And so you really want to be able to get with people, the easiest way, the huddle ups, the books. Again, the type of person that Symmetry attracts is going to understand that you need to do this. So the consistency is doing most days, whether it's 5 pages, you could throw on, a podcast. I mean, it's so easy, but remember, the things that are easy to do are also easy not to do. Mm-hmm. So you have to make the commitment at least 5 out of the 7 days to work on yourself, work on your mindset. Everything else will take care of itself.
Yeah, that is so awesome, Bridge. Well, thank you for all that. We have so many quality people on this call. But what I found is every day when we hear something, we should be growing, right? So we should hear something different, because hopefully we're improving. So again, how proud I am of you, how you're coming along. You're improving your Zoom background, so I'm happy with that. Thank you so much for—
You're welcome. Thanks, Dave.
And I love you.
Love you too.
Okay, so we are moving on. The next gentleman I'd like to introduce, I hope he's not hyperventilating, because I know he's a little nervous, but he's gonna do awesome. He is direct to one of our superstars in our agency, Miss Paige Johnson. I think everybody at this point knows Paige. She's unbelievable. And she recruited Mr. Tom, you want to unmute yourself there, buddy? That's a nice logo, by the way. There he is. Tom just earned an agency owner last month. And he's been with us about 19 months, buddy, something like that?
Yeah.
Yeah. And he's another one I am so proud of. And he is going to talk a little bit about the effort, right? It's attitude first, effort second, and then I'm going to talk a little bit about some skills. And so Tom is one of the hardest workers I've ever met. He really is. He works on his attitude. He works on his working, right? He works on his self-improvement. So welcome, Tom, and thanks for joining us here. By the way, that shirt looks awesome. Yeah, ironed it and everything, didn't it, for the call?
It did.
Talk a little bit about effort. I'm just going to let you kind of run with it. But what does that mean to you in terms of your journey so far here with Symmetry?
Well, thanks, Dave, for that. And, you know, the journey started with what Bridget just said to me. It sounded like those were my initial mentoring calls over and over and over again. So, Bridget, thank you for everything that you've ever poured into me from the beginning. And Tom Ellison, yes, new agency owner, 1 month, and direct to the great Paige Jensen. And I'm so proud to be part of that. And in the Felix Lappin, Ziller, Miller, Puckett, Wayland hierarchy. I'm damn glad to be so, right? You know, the definition of effort, Dave, and oh, by the way, the founders, thanks for having a young AO on a call today. That's so awesome.
Absolutely.
Grateful to be invited. And, you know, effort as a definition is a vigorous or determined attempt. And, you know, in symmetry, sometimes, you know, effort falls when there's not an immediate payoff or you become distracted. And we stop putting in the effort, you know, when we do get distracted. And, you know, I've always thought of there's these get ahead days where we leap ahead of the rest of the field who are not putting in, you know, all the effort, right? And I think I grabbed this from Summit, you know, and I've kind of made it mine. This process, my process was messy. And, you know, my process is now, you know, becoming my message. And it is the effort. And, you know, I said this on a call the other day, you don't manage your time, you manage your focus. You know, Rome wasn't built in a day. It was built one day at a time for over thousands of days consistently. You know, that's focus. That's effort every day, right? That's, you know, this is your life, your results. You know, how can you not invest deeply in the effort and the consistency? And the I'll go into this with intentional effort, you know, and thanks for the compliment on the hardworking. That's been a strength of mine. And that's one of the reasons that attracted me to Symmetry is I could finally put in the hard work and get the results for the work that I put in, right? Mm-hmm. And intentional effort, you know, here's what it looks like. When you start out, it's showing up each and every day on every call or every training when you feel like you don't know anything in this business, right? It's jumping on the Zoom dial rooms, you know, being in the community, putting in the activity, the dials, the appointments early on, even if your ratios are way off or whatever, right? And also for me in the beginning, I had to borrow belief from Carl and John early on those huddles. And then it also transitioned into another level of belief because my wife borrowed belief in me to allow me to dream and be this best version of me here. And that's, you know, that's just another level. And you know, intentional effort again is doing the work when you don't feel like it. You know, I'm going to put it out there today. I'm setting a goal in front of the whole company to retire my wife in 2 years.
That's intentional effort. Right. Let me jump in, buddy. Yeah. So good. You know, I just love to see, and I know all the leaders in our company do, and we see our people growing. And you can just see Tom growing. He's like the little flower and he's really growing big. And I just love it. I mean, what you're saying, how you're saying it, how you conduct yourself, that is just all a factor of your personal growth, right? And yeah. So for those of you who are new on the call, if you don't like hearing about personal growth, this is not the place for you because this is all about developing yourself as a person. Because your results will fall in line if you develop yourself as a person. So talk about him, you know, so Tom is an extremely hard worker. So like he's a dialer. I mean, he doesn't have to dial as much now because he has A leads and he's gotten very good, but he still is a grinder. But so when we talk about effort, it could be effort in reading, effort in dialing, effort in this. So effort's a big subject, okay? Why don't you talk about a slice of effort that I don't think we talk about a lot, which is how you exerted effort to make more money vis-a-vis your issue rate.
Yes, that's, you know, jump That's so good because, you know, it goes back to the intentional effort. It goes back to, you know, I was struggling in November. I was struggling with issue rate. I was struggling with, you know, my business was a little upside down, as John would say. But, you know, the intentional effort is having that conversation first with my wife, figuring out, you know, hey, how long are you going to keep doing it like this, right? And then coming with open arms and an open heart to my mentors, to Paige, to John, to you, to Bridget, and say, hey, how can I get better? What do I need to do? And basically, it was started over, taking the skills that I had learned, but starting over and really focusing on instant issue, SBLI, AmeriCo, everything like that. And really slowing down. I was getting excited and I had to really slow down in the appointment and really listen more. And that was the thing that I was missing. I wasn't listening enough. And that was one of the biggest things. And then, you know, I was, you just keep growing, right? I focused on what I could control. I reached out daily. I learned the skills. And Dave, I'm so glad for you to share what you're going to, you know, pour into everybody today to let them know how you poured into our team as well. And, you know, my strength was always the effort. Bridget and Paige helped me match the activity and the skills that were developed. And there's no way I would have made it without that intentional effort and the learned activity at all. Does that answer the question?
It does, buddy, because, you know, I just wanted you to, you know, kind of paint the picture of, again, it's like when someone says attitude, there may be a one-dimensional mindset towards that. Mm-hmm. And it's a big subject, as is effort. And I know that you've worked really hard at the, you know, so the traditional description would be make more calls. Okay, well, that's important. That's important. But that's just one piece of the puzzle. And so I've been so impressed with you, because putting effort in to improve your issue rate is, that's profitable effort, right? Because yeah, it doesn't matter what we sell, it's what we keep. Like I said, this gentleman, Jeremy, I just that little blip they had, you know, closers or losers. And I would agree with that, because the better we get at this business, we're not salespeople. And I know people think of that, but you know, your traditional fast talking at people type of person, they don't win here. This really is consultative. And it's being honest with people, you know, good, bad, or ugly. And so your effort to learn all that has been really, really impressive. So in the spirit of time, since Bridge went long, what would you like? Because again, we could talk all day about effort. What's something maybe we haven't touched on that you want to share with people that's helped you get to where you are, which is just putting a jersey on, right? Now you're in the game. But I know you're passionate about this subject. So what else would you like to add in closing on effort?
Well, sure. And thank you. You know, I love that metaphor that Darren used. I kind of was thinking, you know, becoming AO is you finally find that last piece of the puzzle and you put it in and you turn away for a second and you look back and the puzzle just got immensely bigger.
Right.
You're like, I just put that last piece in, but no, you know, it's to share here on the effort, it's be intentional with your effort. And, you know, Bridget always, I love how she said this, you snuggle the struggle, right? And it's having that intentional effort, however difficult, it will lead to the amazing results. And, you know, I don't remember who said this first, but your level of success will never exceed your level of personal development ever. I was told day one, you got to self-development. I was like, okay, whatever. I read. It took me conference last year, the Wayland conference, to learn how to journal, and been journaling ever since. But, you know, and here's what I'll say, and I'll turn it back to you, you know. Everybody on this call, are you willing to put in the intentional effort, your intentional, meaningful effort? trust yourself, you know, live your life and start growing from the inside right now.
Yep. That is so good, buddy. Well, thank you. And I really am. I'm so proud of you. And I'm so excited about what your life's gonna be as we go down the road. Because again, I just can't say it enough. There is so many sharp, good people at this company. I mean, I'm just amazed. Every time somebody talks, it's like, wow, they're delivering some good information for us. So thank you for that. I really appreciate it. I might have forgot to thank Brandon, Brian, and Casey. I know they're not on, but Todd and Brian. And so, yeah, it's such an honor to be on a call like this. So what I want to do, guys, is I want to, so we did attitude, and I thought Bridge did a great job of giving some thoughts, Tom. So I'm going to talk a little bit about the skills, because we have this incredible system, right? We have Fast Track, we have Summit, we have Quality U. Unbelievable. I mean, I'm a little bit older than a lot of people. Next month I'll be, and so I've seen a lot of things, and I've been approached by a lot of things. I've done a lot of things, and the system that Symmetry has now in terms of training, unbelievable. It really is unbelievable. I love what Danny Young says, right? If you can't make money here, it's like living in a grocery store and starving to death. You're simply not paying attention or even trying. So if that's the case, get out. It's not for you. Or start taking advantage of the resources. Okay. So all I want to talk about today is something I don't think we talk about a lot, is in the sales process. I want to cover two things. I would encourage you to write this down. I have been the beneficiary of some unbelievable trainers. My stepfather, Rod Troutman, who many of you know, has been the biggest influence and mentor in my life. And I've had people who have taught me how to sell, how to train. And so I appreciate the nice words earlier from Todd and Brian, but I'm just a beneficiary of some great leaders, as well as, you know, this is before Symmetry. And once I came to Symmetry, it's exponentially gone up. So I really feel strongly about sharing a few ideas that I really hope people will use, because it will help you in your business. And this is just what I've done, what we teach on. And there are two areas of the sales process that don't get talked about a lot. Here's the one thing I want to ask everybody. I wish we could see all these hands. How many agents last week, we'll do a virtual hand, how many agents last week visited with someone, right, that should have gone forward, but they didn't, right? So there's 1,300 people on here. There should be about 1,250 hands up, okay? So we're not talking about difficult people. We're talking about nice people who everything seemed good, but they didn't move forward, okay? So we know that's out there. And I think a lot of people are stumped as to why that happens. So I'm just gonna share with you why I think it happens and what I've learned to do over the years. Talking to Bridge earlier, I got into direct sales at age 20, and I'll be 60 in September. So I've done it a couple of times. I was trying to factor in how many one-on-one sales situations I've had. I think it's about 16 or 17,000. So that's me sitting with John and Mary trying to get them to move forward on a product or service. If you want to know how to sell in corporate America, I don't know how to do that. That's not been my world. Mine has been business to consumer. So I like to think I've got a reasonable understanding of how people make decisions and what causes them to be put off, okay? So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna talk first and foremost on the importance of, you know, we have our system, right? Step one, step two, step three, step four. So this is just something I wanna share. If you like it, great. If not, discard it. Like Jim Rohn says, it's like a cafeteria. Take what you like and don't take what you don't like. So, but under the banner of missing one last week, what if we could just pick up one more every week, not get one, get an additional one, because we're better in the sales process. That's what I'm talking about, is the sales process. Average commission's what? 700 bucks, something like that, 600-700 bucks. So if we could get one more a week, that's what, 2,800 bucks a month, something like that, give or take. So let's just call it 3 grand for easy math. So if we could get $3,000 extra Now, I'm not talking 3,000 in earnings. I'm talking 3,000 extra by handling two key parts of the sales process I think are important. That's what I want to help everybody with, because boy, I get so passionate about helping people, because when you get one versus you don't get one, not only is it an emotional roller coaster for you, you're not helping that family and you're not helping your family. And those people, we can help them if we know what to say at the critical time. So here's one thing. What we always talk about is, before I show the quotes, and everybody's got their own style, but in my view, you should be getting a little commitments along the way to make sure that they're with you, they're on board. Well, what we do, the beautiful thing about our business is you could show up and I say, hey, Tom, how are you? Hey, here's my license. Here's the quotes. Which one do you want? We literally could say that and a couple people would do it, because we're working with warm leads, but we're talking about getting better than 2 out of 10, right? We're talking about 7, 8, or 9. So all I want to share is what I've done since the beginning of time, because this is what I was taught from another business. Before I show any money, I'm going to make sure someone's on board with me. Okay. And how I do it is, let's say someone has been good the whole way. Yeah, well, I want to make sure. So in other words, it's going well. My opinion is, if they're really good and I just confirm they're on board, that's never going to hurt me, ever. But if I don't confirm they're on board, it can lead to a lot of problems. So all that sounds like is, Bridge, if you want to unmute, I would just say, hey, Bridge, I got some quotes here. I think I know the answer. I just want to double check. It sounds like if we can find something that fits in the old budget and we can get you qualified, which is no guarantee. That's why we have to do the application. It sounds like that you like this idea and that you feel it would be important to have a policy like this. Am I reading you correctly?
Yep, exactly.
Okay, so that's it, guys. That's my question, to make sure she's on board with me. Okay, if she's good, it's really powerful for people to hear themselves say, yep. And it's real powerful for old grumpy John to hear Mary say it. So there's a real value in getting people to say, yes, I'm on board with you. You can never go wrong, but you say it in a very assumptive, respectful manner. Hey, I think I know the answer, but just out of respect, I just want to, and I smile, hey, I just want to double check. And you ask a question, am I reading you correctly? And Bridget will say yes. The second thing is, Bridget will say yes with a qualification to it. So let's do that real quick, Bridge, since we're doing sales training. So Bridge, make sure I'm reading, so we'll just start with, am I reading you correctly?
Oh, yeah.
In your role playing.
And I want to just, I want to check, we've got another policy. I don't know where it is, but I just kind of want to look at some finances first.
Okay. So that wasn't a very good yes, was it? So we used to talk about, there's a difference between a yes and the yes. Okay. So don't be that difficult. Just say it depends on money. So let me do it again, because everybody that's watching, tell me you don't get this all the time. So Bridge, I just want to double check. It sounds like if we can fit something in your budget and we can get you qualified, which there's no guarantee of that, but if we can, it sounds like you like this idea and you feel it would be a benefit and important, right? To have something like this for when your time comes. Am I reading you correctly?
Well, sure. I mean, it just depends on how much it is.
Ah, how often does that happen? Now, my experience is, hold on, Bridge, let me show you. If I rush into the quotes, they very well may move forward. They very well may not, because I'm not so sure she's on board. So what do you say? God only knows what we're saying. So here's what I would recommend. I would say, got it, Bridge, totally understand. What I found over the years in helping families get protected is that if somebody, feels this is important, we can always usually find a number that they like. Now, if they don't feel it's important, guess what? We never find a number, because none of us spend money on things we don't feel is important. So I guess all I was asking you is, you know, do you feel like having a policy like this would be a good idea and important for your family?
Yeah, definitely.
So if you will do that, guys, they will clean their answer up, and then I would be glad to show the quotes. But so that's a formula. Make sure they're on board, and if they give you anything other than a good clean yes, just go back and try to clean it up. Because what I found is people appreciate that, because they know if they're not on board, they're not going to do it. So again, this will be recorded, but that has worked really well for me forever. I don't really talk about money until I know people are on board. And if we do the presentation right and we do enough of them, we're going to get, remember, we're just talking about one extra. We're not talking about fixing all of the problems, one extra. And everybody listening, how many people go through that with clients just like we did? Everybody does. Now, if you don't know what to say and how to dance that dance, God only knows what you're going to do. And what I meant earlier about understanding psychology, I used to be a young, you know, hard charger when I first got in the business. And back then, which was a while ago, is there was a big belief in the world of selling or business, how to overcome objections. Okay. And I know there's still people out there that talk about that. And I think it's important to some degree. What I think we need to do is know how to get out in front of objections before they happen. So I'm always real nervous about saying things that make people defensive. Okay. Now here's the second thing I want to talk about. How do you handle somebody who says they want to think about it? So I go over the quotes with Bridge. Let's say I got a good thing with her, a good commitment. And so I'm like, okay, let's move forward. And I go over the quotes of these three or these two, which one makes the most sense to apply for. And Bridget says,
Dave, I'm going to need to think it over. I'm not sure.
The dreaded, I want to think about it, right? If you guys, there's a formula for handling this, in my opinion. If you don't know what to say, it's almost like you're going to throw up. You're so uncomfortable because people say that. We all hate to hear that, but it doesn't have to be that way. If you have a reasonably good response to that, you will convert a whole bunch of people. Here's the thing. I want to be sensitive on time, but this stuff I think is so important, because if you don't know what to say to that and you step on their foot in that dance, you're done. You're just done. Here would be an example of saying the wrong thing. Bridge says, I need to think about it. And even in my best Boy Scout voice, I say, oh, well, no, I understand, Bridge, but what is it that you want to think about? Oh my God, just hang up. You're done. You are absolutely done if you ask that question. Because what in the world are they going to say to you that can help your cause? Nothing.
Nothing.
Nothing. And you're making them defensive. So that's what I mean. You don't want to step on the wrong thing. Another thing I've heard, and again, just my opinion, just my humble opinion, is I found if we put people in a position that they feel we're trying to outsmart them or outwit them, they're going to say no just on principle, because their ego's involved. Now, it has nothing to do with the process. It has to do with the ego. I'm not going to be talked into it. You know, I've heard all kinds of crazy things, so I won't even get into them all. I just want to give you a formula. But whenever someone says, I want to think about it to me, I assume it's a knee-jerk reaction. Okay? So a lot of times people just say it because they say it. And then if we say something stupid next, now we're off in the weeds and we're probably done. And it might not even have been serious. So I always assume it's a knee-jerk. They've been saying that since day one. I need to think about it. They don't need to think about it. But is it a real need to think about it, or was it a knee-jerk reaction? So I would recommend you do two things. Here's the formula. Step one is go back and get a commitment they're on board. Then you provide a solution. What does that look like? A lot of agents do this. Say you need to think about it, Bridge.
I just need to think about it, Dave.
Oh, yeah, I understand. Well, all we're doing today is putting in an application. We don't even know if we can get you approved. All we're going to do, blah, 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 blah. That'll work sometimes, but I don't even know if she's really on board with me. So I'm telling you, if you will go back and get the commitment, then provide the solution. So this is what that looks like. Bridge, tell me you need to think about it.
It sounds good, Dave. I just need to think about it more.
Sure. I totally get it. You know, Bridge, it sounds like, you know, you like the idea, you know, of what this can do for you, and you see how it's going to benefit your family and all that good stuff. But it sounds like you're just not sure which option you want to apply for. Is that kind of where we are?
Yeah, it is.
Okay. Well, if I could make a recommendation, remember I said earlier, all we can do today is put in the application to see if we can get it for you. So what I'd recommend, if you're good with it, is let's go ahead and go through the application and make sure we can get it. And then if you want to change, well, I want to do this, that's easy. The hard part is getting people approved. So like I said, if you're comfortable with it, that's what I would recommend.
Okay, that sounds good.
And guys, how often does it work when you do it that way, Bridge?
Oh, it's money.
Okay, so all you've got to do, guys, is there's a formula for handling, I want to think about it. And if that member, commitment, solution, right? So again, I've seen people just go to the solution or they start to do battle. Well, how long have you been thinking of doing this? I mean, yeah, you know, anytime you put somebody in a defensive mode, I've been selling for 40 years. I've never had somebody say, you know, Dave, you're right. Let's do it. It just never happens. So you've got to massage these, you know, before you go over money and before you, I want to think about it. It's a little thing we don't talk a lot about, but if you get better at it, you can easily get one more a week. Easily. And you'll have less cancellations because people are doing it because they want to do it. So if we talk about closing, if you notice how soft that was. Sounds like you like it. You're just not. Is that kind of where we are versus would you agree with me? You know, that kind of old school hard tie down type stuff. It just doesn't work with people. So you got to be genuine. You got to be nice. And that's really, guys, you know, I could talk all day about this, but because I feel so strongly that just because we work on attitude and we work on effort does not mean we can't work on our skills. And that doesn't mean we've got this incredible system as a foundation. Now, let's start getting better at the system that Symmetry has laid out for us. Then life gets easier, money's better, families are protected, referrals. So a higher conversion rate is nothing but good stuff. So you know what, Todd, I looked at the clock. I probably should wrap it up, buddy. But again, thank you for giving us this opportunity. And I hope somebody said something that can really resonate and help somebody that invested in the call today. So again, thank you and back to you, buddy.
Man, so much gratitude to you, buddy. Absolute. Tons of notes, tons of nuggets over here. I've got 7 post-it notes actually on my desk, which is my method of taking them down before I type them up. So I appreciate you. Appreciate you, Bridget. Appreciate you, Tom, to all of our guests today. Thank you for pouring in. Can't wait to see everybody next week on the call. Looking forward to seeing everybody in Denver in less than a month's time now with all of our featured speakers and also the opportunity to get together on Friday night at the block party and celebrate and do some association. So thank you to everybody out there, and we all will see you next week.
All right. Thank you, guys.
Thanks, guys.